This morning, we're talking about a pretty common condition for adults over the age of 60. Symptoms of diverticulitis might include stomach pain or fever. Some people, though, may not have symptoms at all. Dr. Jay Pirtle is a gastroenterologist at LeBauer Gastroenterology and a member of the Cone Health Medical Group. Good morning, Dr. Pirtle.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
I think a lot of people know about stomach problems, but this is specific. Diverticulosis and diverticulitis. Describe what's going on there.
Right. So diverticulosis is the presence of these pockets or outpouchings that line the colon. And you often don't know that you have diverticulosis. We see it fairly commonly at colonoscopy for screening. It's primarily asymptomatic. And so when it becomes symptomatic is when you learn about it and usually need medical treatment. So diverticulitis is an infection or inflammation of the pocket that lines the colon.
Right.
The symptoms include abdominal pain, fever, poor appetite, and oftentimes needs treatment.
Now, you mentioned this can often be seen or at least detected during a colonoscopy. Can you deal with it there? Is it something that you need to deal with because it could lead to further things later on, maybe cancer?
No, it tends to not be related to cancer, and oftentimes it's asymptomatic. Fortunately, it's only about 5%, 5 to 10% of patients that have diverticulosis will get diverticulitis. Diverticulosis is common. About 60% of patients at age 60 will have these pockets, but fortunately, it rarely becomes infected. When it does, then you develop the symptoms and seek treatment.
If people want to avoid it, what's the best way to do it? Clean up your diet, maybe you know, eat the right kind of things that we all should be eating?
Right, so risk factors include a low fiber diet, so high fiber diet is going to make it less likely. People that are less physically active, and obesity and being overweight are also risk factors.
So as well as tobacco. Get moving. Doctors say, you know, walking helps in a lot of ways. This is certainly one of them.
Correct. Exactly right. And so, fortunately, treatment is in general fairly easy. People get antibiotics, bowel rest, focus on hydration and fluids. And usually after about a week of antibiotics, people are getting better.
When we talk about diverticulitis, though, the pain level, I've heard it described as really, really intense.
Well, usually it starts out fairly mild. You may not exactly know what's going on, but it does progress. And so over a day or two, it can become quite intense. Some patients do wind up needing to go to the hospital. And it can become complicated. And so being able to identify it early can prevent complications such as needing to be in the hospital or needing to have an abscess pocket or drained.
Okay, well, thanks for telling us about it. I think a lot of people have questions. They hear the term and they're not really sure what it means. Well, we appreciate you talking about it today. Hey, here's a great opportunity to learn more about colorectal cancer. We told you about this earlier in the week. Cone Health sponsoring an interactive exhibit called Strolling Colon, and it lets you walk inside an inflatable colon, get a better understanding about how to prevent cancer and kind of have a healthier lifestyle. Two opportunities. First one coming up Saturday, March 10th from 11 to 2 at the Lowe's Foods parking lot on University Drive in Burlington. Or check it out the next Saturday at the same time. They'll be at the Whole Foods Market parking lot, Friendly Center in Greensboro, and they've been there before. Emily, a lot of people have a lot of